to build 4 pounds of muscle in a month naturally.
Sus.
4 pounds of muscle in 1 month for an advanced trainee from one supplement?
I welcome the criticism. And if you see me doing something wrong, absolutely call me up.
I can't deal with this. So I've been feeling a little bit tired recently, working these 100-hour weeks, you know. So I thought I would just outsource this video. A little bit easier. Take it away.
So many companies, supplements, foods, you name it, they're out there to trick you into buying their supplement to make it seem better than it is. And so I'm going to start doing a series on foods that trick you so that you're aware, and then you can do what you want with it. To me, turkesterone seems cheap. To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month for a bit over $100, to me, that's well worth it. I'd easily spend $10,000 to build 4 pounds of muscle in a month naturally. Canadian Food Inspection Agency. And they have certain rules on like what you're allowed to do. And the rules are, they don't care. They just let you do whatever you want. Got zero calories, and this one is 37, so I'm buying this one. So this one loses money. So you can't really blame them for lying.
If someone thinks that everyone is a liar and a cheater, it's easy to justify doing it.
They're lying, flat out. But you can't really blame them because they're trying to make a living. And they know this company is not going to do it.
So lying is okay if you make money while doing it?
I can't gain 20 pounds of muscle in 30 years right now, okay? It's just not possible. If you watch my video from 2012 and my cycle to turn pro, it's freaking high dose stuff. And I put on a couple pounds of muscle.
To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month?
Sus.
Okay, so a friggin' high dose of steroids equals a couple of pounds. Turkesterone equals 4 pounds in 1 month?
Let's say in 10 weeks that you did. Well, that's 20 pounds of muscle in 10 weeks of pure muscle. No one's getting that either, but let's pretend that you did.
Then the clothes start fitting better. I was like, GF9 stuff is the real deal.
And then he says he took his supplements and lost 5.6% body fat while adding almost 6 pounds of muscle. That's awesome. Almost PD-like performance changes.
All right, let me get this straight. So when Shaq, who is 7 foot a million, puts on 5.8 pounds of muscle in 4 months, that is somehow indicative of PEDs, as he implies very heavily, and is unbelievable for a natural supplement. But when he puts 4 pounds of muscle on in 1 month on his, let's admit it, much smaller frame, that is somehow acceptable to say? Does this not seem mildly hypocritical?
Does that make sense? The supplement he's created is in fact better than any PD I can think of. Why use PDs when you can use these all natural supplements, which are better than PDs? Not almost as good, better! But no, it's here, natural, for $200 for 3 boxes. Does that make sense? $200 for 3 boxes. So this one loses money. You can't really blame them for lying. They're lying, flat out. But you can't really blame them because they're trying to make a living.
Okay, so 5.6 pounds in 4 months on one of the biggest frames in the world, impossible. 4 pounds in 1 month on a fairly short guy who has been lifting 30 plus years, integrity?
To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month? I'm sorry if it sounds too good to be true. It's not true! So how am I being dishonest? How do I lack integrity? And you still disagree with me? What is wrong with you? You're clearly a moron. All these freaks, they Wolverines and stuff, they train for 3 months for a movie and put on 15 or 20 pounds of muscle and they say it's from chicken breast. These are liars. These is not true. And they have to lie. They can't say, oh, I took steroids for 3 months and trend and that's how I got muscle. You can't say that. If you're an actor, you can't say it. Expect them to have to lie. You can't get mad at them. That's just how it works.
Okay, so 15 to 20 pounds in 3 months for Hollywood celebs, for short PEDs, 4 pounds in 1 month for an extremely advanced lifter, turkesterone. Also, just because lying in the fitness industry is common does not make it acceptable. Have some moral courage.
Let's say I go for it anyway. 2 months go by, okay? And I put on 10 pounds of muscle because of the anabolic window. Yes! Now I'm 205 pounds and 5% body fat, whatever it is, and I am just a beast.
So a post-contest full-on cycle, 10 pounds in 2 months, Turkesterone is 4 pounds in 1 month? That makes sense.
Now, granted, if I'm off cycle, I'm not going to put on muscle the way I would on cycle. Could I fake a frickin' DEXA scan to put on 20 pounds of muscle? Of course I can do that! You know how easy I can fake this bullshit?
So I'm just including this clip in case he actually tries to do this, which he might.
It's like, you're not at a limit. You can gain 3 or 4 pounds of muscle each year. It's going to keep happening for many, many, many years. Fitness industry, supplement companies created this to sell you supplements to say you're 9% fat and 180. 9 years later, you're 200 pounds and 9% fat. You're always 9% fat. It's not going to happen overnight. Stop thinking you're going to gain 5 pounds of muscle in a month. You're not. Maybe with steroids, but not any other time in your life. It sounds amazing. However, Turkesterone is not as strong as SARMs or steroids. To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month... Is this guy a cult leader? Is it a cult? What is all these followers? But it comes with a price. It's like selling your soul to the devil. How do we do that? If we're natural, we might gain 4 pounds of muscle a year for 10 years and we put on 40 pounds. If we're enhanced, maybe we put 15 pounds of muscle a year for 3 years and we get to the same zone or, well, we get there 3 times faster the whole time, slowly build those 5 pounds of muscle that whole year. And so maybe you're gaining a pound every 2 months. That's just how it works. It's slow and steady. To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month, slow and steady. Muscle. 5 pounds of muscle in a year, natural, is a lot. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally. He takes, for example, 500 tests a week. He could put 10 or 15 pounds of muscle in 3 to 4 months and be like, what? Like, what just happened? I'm so much bigger now. It's not as strong as SARMs or steroids. All the time, great. My genetics suck. I can only gain like 5 pounds of muscle a year. You know, I'm a hard gainer. 5 pounds! Oh, I averaged 3 pounds of muscle a year after my first few years, and I consider myself an easy gainer. How in the hell am I not an easy gainer? I'm an IFBB pro. Build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally. He doesn't have a master's degree in kinesiology, so how do you know? You know, I mean, whatever. Whatever. Let's get on with this. It took me 10 years to put on 30 pounds of muscle, and half of the comments of you guys don't even believe I was natural. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally. It gives hope for all these, you know, these young kids that have no muscle, and they're like, well, if I work out hard, I can gain 50 pounds of muscle too in a couple of years. The facts are most people with gifted genetics in their first year training are going to gain 12 pounds of muscle. Then after that, about 8. Then after that, about 6, and then 4, and then less. It would be tough to argue with anyone that would say, to be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month for a bit over $100, to me, that's well worth it. And the problem is, you're going to join the gym, and you're going to get discouraged because you're not even going to come close to even the bottom of these results. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally. You're only going to gain 4 to 6 pounds, even with really good genetics. I gained about 3 pounds of muscle per year in my 20s. And I said, I have great genetics. And I was gaining 3 pounds of muscle a year. Now, what about when I took steroids? Yeah, I put on like 15 pounds in a year. But that's not the same. Now, as you get closer and closer to that genetic limit, your gains are going to slow. So like when I got to like near the end, I was like, I think I gained a pound this year. But I'm not even sure. I couldn't even tell. I wasn't getting stronger, bigger. It just was stopping, okay? To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month for a bit over $100? Not normal to just gain huge amounts of muscle, okay? If you have extremely good genetics, based on my chart, 12 pounds first year, then 8, then 6, then 4. That's 20, 30 pounds in 4 years natural. If you put on 30 pounds in 4 years natural training, you are a genetic phenom. 5 pounds heavier than he was 3 years prior when he won the overall title, okay? So it's a lot less than that 3 pounds of muscle that you could kind of expect. So he's clearly near his genetic limit here. and the gains are definitely slowing down.
Near your natural limit, gaining about a pound a year of muscle. Turkesterone gaining 4 pounds in 1 month.
If you've been gaining 8 pounds of muscle a year, well, geez, do what you're doing. You're doing amazing. You don't need to do any better. So the massive, crazy, monstrous doses, like when I did 212 bodybuilding compared to now, 8 pounds of muscle difference compared to super unhealthy, not gonna willing to risk my health for that ever again.
So massive, crazy, monstrous doses equals 8 pounds of muscle total. Turk equals 4 pounds in 1 month. Okay, then.
It's like being bloated. Test bloats you. So when you gain 8 pounds, it's not 8 pounds of muscle. If you gain 4 pounds, it's not 4 pounds of muscle. It's maybe half, maybe if you're lucky. So the group that gained 7 pounds of muscle, they might have actually gained 1 pound of muscle. They might have gained zero. I don't actually know if John said, I gained 15 pounds of muscle, or he just gained 15 pounds. I don't know the exact quote. So depending on what he said, you got to take his message with a grain of salt, or perhaps with 5 grains of salt. Pounds in water weight. For example, if Tristan Lee eats a lot of carbs, salt, and water and shows up the next day and weighs 145 pounds, the test is going to say, wow, you put on 5 pounds of muscle in 1 day. But he didn't really put on 5 pounds of muscle. He just ate more, drank more water. So it doesn't know if you're actually gaining muscle or water. It's impossible to know that. Only Coach Greg's laser eyes can do this.
Drop your weapon and step away from Sergeant Sullivan.
I called you. You specifically. Look.
So if he had said he gained 4 pounds, this video would not exist. You can gain 4 pounds of fat or water or whatever, and that's not a ridiculous claim at all. That happens in a month all the frickin' time. If he even said 4 pounds of lean body mass, that would still be fine because you can gain water weight very easily. But he specifically said 4 pounds of muscle. And he even doubled down in the comments. I included those previous clips because he knows the difference between water weight, even water weight in the muscle, and actual muscle tissue that sticks around. And Greg, look at the likes. 11 likes for the other guy, not a single like for you. People are not stupid. And here is more of him doubling down. I'm also curious about, did he change his diet? Did he not add in calories? Because 4 pounds of muscle tissue takes a lot of energy to synthesize. Did he main gain? Did he recomp? Did he stay the same weight? Is he just up 4 pounds? There's a lot of questions that he's not really answering whatsoever. And I think if you're selling a product, your own experiences with the product mean absolutely nothing.
It's like, what are your goals? I want to put on 15 pounds of muscle in the next 4 months natural. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month naturally. I'll be like, you're an idiot. I literally call clients that even hire me idiots anymore. I'll be like, there's no way you're gaining 15 pounds of muscle natural. I don't even care if it's newbie gains in 4 months. You probably reached most of your gains. You don't have a ton left. You're not going to be able to, in 4 months, make a noticeable change. You could maybe gain 1 or 2 pounds. Maybe. That's if you're blessed. It's 4 months. After 10 years of training, you're lucky to gain 3 pounds of muscle in a year. That's 1 pound in 4 months if you're good at math.
Normal advanced training, 1 pound in 4 months. Turkesterone advanced training, 4 pounds in 1 month. Bye, 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 bye.
Is this guy a cult leader versus Coach Greg that says, you can't do it. Even if you hire me, I can't make you gain 10 pounds of muscle in 3 months natural.
To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month naturally.
Who's got a better selling point? Mike, way better selling point. Me saying the truth about you can't gain 10 pounds of muscle, or Mike saying you can completely change your body even if you're at your genetic limit with 30 years of training.
To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month for a bit over $100, to me, that's well worth it.
Better seller, better actor, better truthful person. That's the difference. Put on 5 pounds of muscle this year, my genetics suck. Are you kidding? They're amazing. Literally, everyone's expectations are so high, and I think the reason...
To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally.
...is because people see enhanced transformations that they don't know are actually enhanced. Oh, this movie star put on 14 pounds of muscle in 3 months for their role as Superman or whatever. But they train 4 hours a day and ate chicken breast and rice, so it must have happened. Well, I'm going to eat chicken breast and rice and train like that. Well, I should gain at least 10. No, you're not going to, because it's all BS and they're all anabolic stuff. They're not natty. I'm on 140 milligrams of HRT. At 50 times the dose, I could go on Eric Kanevsky's cycle, and it wouldn't make me gain 10 pounds of muscle.
I don't know, man. This 4-pound claim seems to be getting more and more dubious, in my opinion, of course.
How much bigger could I get if I were to take more PEDs? I could probably gain, I'm going to say, 8 to 10 pounds of muscle if I, like, really went on crazy. It's probably the biggest I ever was maybe 10 pounds more muscle than now.
And you know what pisses me off so much? So many people are seeing these things and they're looking at their own bodies and saying, what the heck am I doing wrong? Why do my genetics suck? I only gained 5 pounds of muscle in 4 months. I have horrible genetics. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally. Because they see these guys gaining 15 pounds or more. And they think that they suck, and so it's ruining it for everybody. Pisses me freaking off to see that these guys are getting away with it.
You are the chosen one!
The 12 pounds of muscle, it only took them longer to get there. To me, that's a lot smarter than blasting on a cycle for 3 months, gaining 12 pounds of muscle. Everyone's saying Griffin can't gain this 15 pounds of muscle in 3 months because everyone's right. Everyone is actually smart and know what they're talking about. Even with PEDs, that would be difficult.
Beginner, gaining 15 pounds of muscle in 3 months on PEDs? Difficult. Beginner, gaining 15 pounds of muscle in 3 months naturally? Impossible. Extremely advanced lifter gaining 4 pounds of muscle in 1 month from an understudied supplement that they're currently selling? Well, priceless.
You can't gain 15 pounds of muscle in 3 months natural. It's not gonna happen. Sorry, not gonna happen. Bradley's saying, oh, the cheat code. This is where it's more spews for more views. There is no cheat code to taking natty supplements that are gonna get you jacked. He's telling you what you want to hear, not what you need to hear. What you wanna hear is to build 4 pounds of muscle in a month naturally. You can gain 15 pounds of muscle in 3 months if you supplement with some over-the-counter vitamins the right way and eat the right foods. What you need to hear is you're not even going to gain 5 pounds of muscle in 3 months natural. So he's already in the 6+ years of training. If he has great genetics, which we're obviously assuming he does, he might gain 2 or 3 pounds of muscle a year. Maybe. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month naturally. Well, I want to do that, but you can't because you're natural. Sometimes you watch someone's gains and it sets up yourself for disappointment. You go into something expecting to gain 10 pounds of muscle in 2 months and you don't, and you're disappointed when in fact you should be pumped that you gained 4 pounds of muscle in 2 months. All too often, people expect to make night and day transformations or physiques in a matter of months. It takes years to do these things. To be able to put on 4 pounds of muscle in a month for a bit over $100, to me, that's well worth it. Only a month later, they put on 5 pounds of muscle and added 30 pounds in their bench press and said, yeah, I don't feel it. You know, the steroids, they don't work. I would have gained that anyway. And it's like, yeah, I'm sure you would have gained 5 pounds of muscle that quickly. Nope. It's not normal to think you're going to put on 20 to 30 pounds of muscle in a year on steroids. Most don't even put on 15 pounds of muscle on a big cycle. Most do not do that. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally. If it was that easy, so many more people would look amazing. But the people who are saying it doesn't work, notice how all of them haven't used it?
The people who are saying it does work, notice how they're all selling it, or fanboys just getting placeboed out of their skulls?
They haven't used it. It doesn't work. It's placebo. You never used it, so how do you know?
Well, I've never jumped off a 20-story building before, but I can use past experiences and observations to make an informed decision and not be a gullible idiot.
You thinking what I'm thinking, partner? Aim for the bushes.
There goes my hero.
In comparison, I've tried it. And I'm telling you what it did for me. So all of you watching this right now say, Turkesterone is impossible that it doesn't work. Have you tried it? Have you tried it? If you tried it and it didn't work, well, hey, that's good evidence. I welcome the criticism. And if you see me doing something wrong, absolutely call me out.
Yes!
Well, I want to do that. To build 4 pounds of muscle in a month, naturally.
I'm calling out the BS. I hate the BS. All the celebrities seem to be doing it. Well, not all, but so many celebrities are doing this, usually in freaking acting roles, but it happens in sport as well. It happens everywhere. So when you see a comment, question it. Don't blindly believe it just because you're reading it on the computer.
And by the way, Past Greg, thank you so much for coming on the channel. And remember, I always know where to find you. Definitely subscribe to the channel, everyone. Like, comment for the algorithm, all the stuff that YouTube people tell you to do. Definitely grab a copy of my book. It will definitely give you a lot of useful and practical information. And guess what? It's even reasonably priced as well. Amazing, I know. Peace.